today, we've got new information to share about fertility. Pregnancy rates through IVF are improving thanks to some breakthrough lab techniques, and they're available here in Seattle. Here with me today to explain is Dr. David Ball from Seattle Reproductive Medicine. Welcome.
Well, thank you.
So tell us about this. There's some brand new stuff, and this is great news, of course, if couples are trying to have a baby and having trouble. You want the rates of success to go up so that this is not such a long and laborious and expensive process as it sometimes can be. What is this first process, ICSI?
Well, the first video we'll show is of intracytoplasmic sperm injection, or ICSI, and it's actually been around for about 20 years now.
What is it?
Well, where we use it typically is when there's some suspicion that we may not get fertilization in the test tube just by putting the sperm and eggs together. So in this case, one of the excellent embryologists we have at SRM will load an individual sperm up into that very small pipette you see there, and will literally inject it right into the egg itself.
Wow, that's what we're seeing microscopically.
Exactly.
So they pick out, you know, I don't mean to be too prosaic about this, but they just pick out a sperm that looks like the best candidate, the strongest swimmer, it's an especially attractive sperm, and they choose that one?
Exactly. Well, okay. Of course, what we want to do is get fertilization, and there are some signs on the sperm to pick to get that, and of course, one of them, we want it to be alive, moving.
Yes.
And secondly, if it's shaped normally, that's a sign that it's a functional sperm as well.
Mm-hmm.
So typically, given a choice, the embryologist will pick those types of sperm to inject into the egg.
Okay, we want a sperm with good self-esteem before it goes to do its job. Now, the second technique we're going to talk about is the specialized incubator with what's called an embryoscope, right?
Yes.
Explain to me what that is.
Well, this is actually, we're working with a European company that's trying to develop this. And as you'll see in the videos coming up, the embryo goes through a bunch of different stages as it grows from fertilization too early on. And on these two, you'll see very early, they look very much the same.
Mm-hmm.
But the one embryo is continuing to develop. It's actually hatching out of the shell, which it has to do before it implants in the uterine wall. The other embryo, even though it looked good early, is kind of falling apart and failing.
And those are mice embryos.
Those are mouse embryos in culture, correct. And of course, what we'd ultimately like to be able to do through use of this technology and other things as well is to identify those embryos that will continue on and be able to hatch out and actually implant in the uterus and give a baby versus those that can't.
So you're just looking again for the best candidate for implantation
so
that people can have a healthy baby.
Successful, exactly.
Exactly. And then the third technique is pre-implantation genetic diagnosis. What exactly is that?
Yeah, well, that one is, this is an interesting technology too. It's been around for a few years now, but increasing to some degree. The point being is, as you can see in the slide here, what we can actually do is take an individual cell out of each embryo that may need to get diagnosed and do a genetic analysis on it to determine which embryo is carrying an inherited disease, for example, cystic fibrosis or a whole multitude of other familially inherited diseases, to identify those that don't carry that disease so we can put only those back and then the baby born won't have the disease.
So all three of these are so interesting scientifically and improving the chances of a healthy baby and a healthy pregnancy. How much has this improved the rate of success for an IVF procedure?
Well, it's interesting. You know, I've been doing this for almost 30 years now, and the progress the field has made is just unbelievable. With these kind of technologies, we're showing some up here today, as well as better treatments for the patients themselves, better management of the treatment cycles, which of course is from the physician end of it. All of it's leading step by step to increased rates. And then the other part of this, of course, is not just getting pregnancies, but getting safe pregnancies.
Right.
And this is where I think some of the lab techniques come into play, where with identifying that one embryo we can put back to give a good, healthy baby one at a time.
And, you know, it must be just a great job when it works, because having been down this road myself in a different area with endometriosis, but knowing what it's like for people struggling with this, when you succeed after all of this effort, it is such a gift. So I can't imagine how happy that makes you and your clients when things work.
Well, it's an amazing field, I think, from at least two sides of it. Number one is helping people achieve what they need in terms of family, but also from a scientific and biological standpoint, it really is fascinating work.
It is.
And I know nobody in this field that doesn't just absolutely love it.
Well, life's a miracle, and so we really appreciate your help.
Thank you,
Dr. Ball.
Nice to meet you.
On our website, you'll find a link for information on what we talked about today with Dr. Ball, and also about Seattle Reproductive Medicine and the very latest on scientific research going on there. We'll link you straight through. Still ahead on the show today, we'll hear from actress Amy Poehler from the hit NBC show Parks and Recreation. And next, an event that no cheese lover should miss. We'll be right back.